Action. Joker, not two. Folie, adieu.
So the winter season is here early. Like, yes. Normally, November is when the big things come. We had Wild Robot
this,
last week. We
I've
got
been
Joker.
Saying this all year. Mm-hmm. Summer was trash.
Everything got...
Buckle up for the next 4 months, because it's nothing but bangers.
A lot of horror movies coming out this month. Beetlejuice, Legs.
We get Venom 3.
We got Venom. We got Smile 2.
Yeah, dog. And we're in October now, so that just puts us ever so closer to Sonic 3, baby. Fuck yeah, dog. Let's go. Joker 2, the sequel to the 2019 movie Joker, that is very critically acclaimed. Mm-hmm. People love Joker. Love
that should not have got a sequel to, which they said there would never be a sequel.
No.
People raged for a sequel.
Who's the director?
Todd Phillips,
that's his name.
People bitched and complained and wanted a sequel. We're getting a sequel, and now the early reviews are...
Why'd they make a sequel?
Genius, because everyone on the planet asked for one.
Because the first one made over $1 billion.
Right, so of course they're going to make a sequel. It's DC. It's Warner Brothers. They're making the Minecraft movie.
It's the reason that first Joker movie is the reason why Sony keeps trying to make bad guy movies. Because, hey, they did it with Joker.
I think, was Sony first?
Sony was first.
Venom might have been 2018, I think.
Yeah, but I mean, I think they keep doing it because, well, that made $1 billion. Eventually, we'll get to $1 billion on one of these bad guy movies. It's never going to happen.
It's never going to happen. I don't agree with there being a sequel to this, to the first movie, because the first movie in the bubble...
Very self-contained, right?
Very self-contained. Has really nothing to do, like, with DC other than, like...
No, they took a concept and then wrote a story around... Just an idea. Like, oh, this Joker person, let's give him our own unique twist.
Let's give him an
origin.
That doesn't previously exist.
Right.
Right.
I'm fine with that.
And there's mentions of Wayne's. Alfred is in it.
You gotta do a little.
Kid Bruce Wayne is in it. You know what I mean? So it's like...
That's fine. That
we're
grounds
in
you
Gotham,
into the Gotham
We're in
world.
Gotham. Yeah. So that's all fine. This one, giving them, like, another DC character to play, like, alongside Joker, like Harley Quinn... Mm-hmm. It's really weird, because it's like...
Because they...
Joker does so well because Joker is like... Joaquin Phoenix is like fucking crazy. Arthur Fleck is his character name. He's like crazy, like schizophrenic.
Right.
Doesn't know what's real or not. Like, but the second you put him with another character who's equally as messed up, but they're like conjoined crazy, it's like to the where they're both like in their... In the same deluded world is like that doesn't really make a lot of sense. Like, I can.
I feel like it's going to be trying to be a commentary of what we've got going on and how people can believe in
anything.
Sanity.
Yes,
because
that's
the,
very much
the main
Joker.
Person who is
everyone's
insane.
Rooting for Joker
right.
in the first movie.
Sound familiar?
Right, because it's like, oh, he's against the man. You know? Yeah. Except his hair is green, not orange.
Yeah, and it's
sweet. Heyo! Yeah.
We see how that works in real life.
Harlem Globetrotter music, fucking... Give it to me. The first one makes sense, though, because it's like, you don't know what's real as an audience member, and Arthur Fleck doesn't know what's real as a character. This one, I fear that it's gonna be like, is it really happening? Like, I can assume all the musical numbers are gonna be in both of their heads, but how are both of them having the same... hallucinations/delusions.
Maybe
right?
like
I don't
Lady
know
Gaga
yet.
Is doing the dance in a song and doing all these things, but then like meanwhile Arthur Fleck's just standing there, like in the real world. You know what I mean?
I don't know, because the trailers make it seem like they're both singing and dancing together.
Yes.
At all times.
But that doesn't mean that they're both together actually doing it. One could be hallucinating that they're singing and dancing with the other person, even though they're not even in the same room.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yes. I could see that. Maybe Harlene Quinzel. I don't think is. I think it's Lee in this one. I think it's just Lee, right? Because they have to have normal people names. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think she is like she's a big fan of like Joker because she's also crazy. But it's like they have this relationship, and then like maybe Joker doesn't feel the same way, but her delusions like make it seem like they're a couple. Like which is kind of like the comic, kind of like the cartoons.
Yeah.
Like I don't know. We're talking box office, not. Theories about the movie.
Yeah, but it's not.
I'm going to see it tonight.
It's
so,
okay to bring that up because
I've already seen it. Yeah.
This now, the tracking when this was announced was like more than the first one. This is going to be a smash again.
Okay.
And then as we've gotten closer to the date and as the details, like what we're talking about and speculating on, have come out, people are like,
maybe not. Yeah.
And I know musicals are a hard sell. They are.
Especially when you don't tell people it's a musical.
That happened with Mean Girls. It happens when...
I've talked to people where they're like, I'm really excited to see Joker 2. I'm like, you know, it's a musical, right? And I watch their like face like sag. Yeah.
So they're, like, so instead of just being like, it's a musical and having a lower box office, but maybe better legs for people who like musicals, they're going to pretend it's not a musical to get a bigger opening. And that thing is going to drop like a rock when you
because
find
people
out.
Realize
and
it's a musical.
Comic book nerds are like, what did you do? What'd and you on do? Top of that, they didn't like Greatest Showman where they wrote a bunch of awesome Academy Award winning songs. They're like, let's spend music right money.
Let's license other popular songs. Which that's, I think is, it's awful.
There are like, rumors that of the $200 million budget, 150 of it is
song rights.
Is song rights.
Better be good, man. Better be
if
good.
If you're doing the same budget as the first movie, but in an extra $150 million just on song rights, that's the pressure. Like this movie now has to make $700 million to break even, maybe, if not more.
And it won't.
It's not going to.
No.
This is going to be like Aquaman 2 level stuff here, guys. Like, I don't think...
I think it'll have like a legs until Venom comes out, and I think Venom will knock this thing on its ass.
See, I think this
they're promising a lot for Venom with the null announcement. That was
they're
their
trying.
That was their trump card.
Well, they also like, announced Tom Holland new deal.
Right.
Feige's working now with them on this on
Andrew
any
Garfield
of their
just came out and was like, I want to go back to acting and stop my hiatus from acting. So it's like they're cooking.
Well,
over
there's
there.
Always that since we're talking box office stuff, there's always that possibility that Sony pulls their head out of their ass, lets Kevin Feige run it, and then you have another world that opens up that they can do with. So I get that.
Joker 2 can't.
This doesn't
that.
Do anything.
No.
They're not making a third one.
No.
They've already, there's no way.
And it's set too far in the past to just throw Batman in.
Yeah.
Or Joaquin Phoenix's Joker will be too old for Batman to even fight. So it's like, I really don't care where it's going. I didn't need a sequel to 2019 Joker.
Nope. Joaquin Phoenix is... And he dropped out of movies. People are coming out and saying that's not the first time he's done that. He's got bad press. Like, this is the perfect storm of a bad movie.
Yeah, Lady Gaga had good press for that one movie she was in with Bradley Cooper. But
Star is Born, yeah.
She hasn't been in anything else since,
yeah,
I don't think.
It's actually weird. She hasn't done a lot. I'm curious. I'm, like, morbidly curious of how this is going
to
be.
I'm excited to go
the
see it.
The tracking is between 55 and 60.
Okay.
It was originally tracking in spring at 120 million opening.
Oh, my God. Oh my God,
she's going the wrong. It's there. Everything I've read is it's almost on a exact trajectory of Flash. Like when, like everyone's like, Flash. That Flash movie is going to be. What's happening? You canceled the whole DC. You know what I mean? Like that's we're getting the same trajectory on that. Yeah. So.
Yeah, and like it's going to be weird because like you have the Penguin show coming out.
I know.
This all another goes back. Batman villain has back. His own show right now, and a Joker movie is going to come out.
During the run, which is in a different universe of the other one, which is also in a different universe of the third one. This is what we've been talking about for over a year, and everyone's like, oh, you guys just drone on and on. But this is the mistakes that James Gunn has made now, because you have three separate universes still running.
And to be fair, he didn't start them, but he's dealing with them.
He's dealing with
very poorly.
He canceled the fourth one,
yeah.
But didn't do anything else about the rest of the stuff.
Right. Yeah.
So like, why would anybody want to see this? I'm going to go... I want to say under.
I'm going to say under.
But I think...
I don't think it breaks 50.
I think it'll just get there, and then it's going to... Then this next weekend, it's going to drop like 60, 70%.
It won't have legs.
It's going to be
no.
bad.
Yeah. I'm going to say under. I'm going to say 45 million concrete.
Okay.
I'm going to say it does not break 50 at least.
And you're going... You get to see it early.
I'm going to see it. I've either... Depending on when this is being posted, I've either already
seen it. He's seen it like a week before the movie has come out.
I saw it on Monday. So
yeah.
Let's say that. Yeah. With a packed theater, by the way. I loved it. It was great. 10 out of 10.
Yeah, this is the only real big release this weekend.
Yes.
Next weekend after we've got, I think, Smile 2.
Smile 2. And then Venom.
Then Venom the week after that.
Or Venom might be the last weekend of October.
Something like that.
I'm not sure. But yeah.
You pull up
I have to double check that.
Little chart.
Smile 2, I'm really excited for. We've got some great movies these past couple weeks, minus Megalopolis. Got some great movies this past week, you know, these past couple weeks. Transformers 1 was great. Wild Robot was a decent fucking movie, man, despite our review.
Yeah, Megalopolis really drug down the average, though.
Yeah, it did.
Like, we saw a lot of decent movies.
Yeah.
Like, Wild Robot was definitely decent. It was good. It wasn't great. It was good.
Yeah.
Wolves was
good.
Okay to good, not great.
Yeah.
But Megalopolis, yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
There's a...
Mm. Are we both under for Joker?
I'm going to go... I'm going to go even, like we always say. I think it gets in...
The 50s?
Between the 50 and 60, but I don't see it. I see that, that's it. It's gonna be like Flash. It's gonna drop like a rock. That movie opened to like 55, 58 million and barely broke 100 million.
Oof. In its entire run.
Domestically.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember joking because it took like 3 weeks to equal what Ant-Man 3 did in its opening weekend, and that was not a good box office movie.
Yeah, and Michael Keaton coming back for Flash.
That only
out Ezra Miller.
Exactly. That's the only reason it made any money.
This one, it's like, well, Joaquin Phoenix is like kind of an asshole, and like nobody asked for a sequel.
Yeah, people
to
like
this
Lady
movie.
Gaga, but that's it. So that's, she's gonna have to carry the whole movie now.
But the first one is like a masterpiece.
That's why you don't make sequels to masterpieces.
Like, and it's not like, oh, it's the best movie ever made.
No,
but it's like,
but
it's
in
really
the genre,
good.
Like, you can see it every time. Go to The Dark Knight. That movie is amazing. Then they made The Dark Knight Rises, and is it fine? It's fine.
Yeah. It works as a finale to the trilogy.
Is it anything like?
It's not good.
No.
Not
great. You know why? Because they had to rewrite it because Heath Ledger died, and they didn't need to make, don't make a
sequel. Don't make a sequel. Yeah. Especially, don't make a sequel, because then you open it up to the possibility of,
well, maybe we'll get a trilogy.
Yeah, like, exactly. The second you say there's a second one, people are like, well, there's got to get a third one.
We don't need Jock Threer,
yeah. That's exactly. Yeah, and this might not be the only bomb left either. Like,
really?
I'm going to say it's a bomb because of the
box.
You think
Sonic 3 is
going to
flop?
No, I think Gladiator 2 is going to faceplant. And I feel bad for Pedro
Pascal. Does that come out this month?
It comes out
November,
December. Yeah.
November, by the way, I didn't know what November movies came out. We get, Gladiator 2, Moana 2, we still get, which blows my fucking mind that there is so minimal hype for Moana 2 right now.
November, December
comes out
crazy.
In 2 months.
Mufasa, Sonic 3, like by the end of the year, Wicked 2,
Wicked. My God, dude.
That's what I mean.
We're stacked for the end of the year. We're stacked.
Joker.
Yeah, man.
Beginning of the year, I would have said this is a top 10 movie for the year,
grossing.
Box office wise.
Yeah.
I don't think so now.
No.
I don't, this is going to make less than Beetlejuice 2, a 40-year-old sequel.
Right. Yeah. And this is a sequel to a 4-year-old movie, 5-year-old movie. You know what I mean? Yeah. So those are our theories. Those are our speculations. We did box office over under. We'll have a review out before this, probably.
And actually, a good tag to this, because I know we were talking about earlier, is we can just mention that we were, I think, did we both say under on Wild Robot or over? It was over. I feel like we both said a little over.
I think we said over.
It was just over.
We were wrong, right?
No, it was over.
Oh, okay, cool.
It was around 30 to 35.
Okay, cool.
So I just wanted to mention that as a thing. And Megalopolis, $120 million budget. $4 million.
Oh, no.
Domestic opening weekend. No. Deadpool and Wolverine, and it's 11th weekend, I want to say, 10th, 11th weekend, made just under $3 million.
We both said over.
Yeah.
On a prediction of 25 to 32 million.
Nailed it. Said over. It was over by three.
Nice. Mm-mm. Okay.
So, see, I just wanted to mention some
of
those
things. Yeah.
Deadpool and Wolverine is also about $5 million away from passing Barbie domestically.
Hell
so I'm
yeah.
like, please do
nice.
It.
Nice. Cool.
That comes out October 1st on digital, probably already out when you've seen this because
okay.
I recorded it earlier. So.
Hell yeah. Nice.
So that's box office stuff.
Sweet. Joker 2.
Put a little smile on your face.
Yeah, I mean,
it is a great movie, whereas this one is like, hey, what if we just took all the questions you had at the end of the first Joker movie and then answered them for 2 hours straight? And I'm like, I didn't want answers to those questions. I didn't want you to...